This is the Killing Floor High Gain Boost. Excuse me while I straighten my spectacles, from Seymour Duncan of the USA, made in the same facility that they build their brilliant pickups. I like this pedal because it's got one little toggle switch and one big knob and a huge sound. In fact, we've got gain from 0 through to about 34 dB, and it's got a bluesy, granny type of... I'm calling it a modern version of a classic old Rangemaster, but it has a few more uses, I think, than the older Rangemaster. All right, let's start with the fundamentals. This is a Music Man Ernie Ball Music Man Axis. I'm running into the front end clean channel of an MI Audio Iron Duke amplifier. It sounds like this. A nice neutral clean tone to start with. This toggle switch will give you a high boost at about 10k, or in the middle it'll just be flat, you'll just get the extra drive, or down on the bottom level it will have a cut at about 4.8k to take some of the sizzle out. So I'm just going to start it in the center position where it's flat, and again the clean tone, turning the Killing Floor on, straight away we've got a nice buffered, a bit more mid-range in there. And as we get, you know, closer to noon, it's really pushing the front end of the amp. Excuse me while I straighten these glasses again, and giving it a bit of a kick. But now we also have the added option of giving it a high boost. Which gives the, you know, the guitar a bit more sparkle. So if I go to the neck pickup where it's kind of dark, and turn the Killing Floor on, I can ride my volume knob all the way and still get that beautiful sparkle. Or I can cut that sparkle out by hitting the high cut. But I still get that beautiful buffered tone. And the more I push it, of course, the louder it's going to kick the front end of the amp. Almost turning it into a cranked plexi, and my god, it is very bloody loud in here. I'm going to go to the boosted channel of my amplifier now, and we're going to do the same thing. So it sounds like this. So in the neutral position, high boost. So it has that bluesy kind of grain about it, but it also tightens things up because it's kicking the front end of the amp with that extra frequency. If I hit the high cut down here, do the same thing again, turn it off, back pickup. Just beautiful. High boost. Great pedal. So many uses. I'm going to now swap this guitar for a single coil equipped Music Man Cutlass, which has Ernie Ball's own sort of mid-60s vintage sounding pickups in it. Much lower output. Now the high boost is probably too much of those pickups, so I might use the high cut. It throws all that bottom end back in. Or the neutral position, or flat position as they call it. The booster channel of my amplifier. So many uses. So simple, looks great, performs well, probably saps, you can run it from 9 to 18 volts too, so if you want more headroom, I'm running it at 9 volts at the moment, but you want more headroom, run it at 18 volts, no problemo. Works great with single coil guitars or humbuckers, through a clean channel, through a dirty channel, Seymour Duncan's Killing Floor High Gain Boost, very, very impressive.